welcome back to another Friday Fruit. Back in the office. It's Friday morning. Chapel's about to get kicked off, but I wanted to just take a second to talk through a couple things with you. But what if I said there's only really two types of people? The other day in class, I was talking about using the example of two different patches of scripture. One was the woman at the well, and then the other one was the demon-possessed man. So in both cases, let me try to set the scene for you. Jesus has gathered the disciples, and they are going to go minister. So the first scenario is the woman at the well, and they go to Samaria, which was hostile environment, whatever, all sorts of racial tensions. So they didn't want to quite go. Then when they get there, they're like, we're hungry, we need food. Jesus sends them off to get food, and he has a conversation with the woman at the well and tells her, you know how that story goes, tells her she's in sin, stop doing what she's doing, like calls her out on some things. She goes back into the town and she, goes against the grain of everything, like culture, like all this other stuff. She was known as, this promiscuous woman. She goes against all that, and she goes back into town, and she says, listen, y'all need to come see this guy. He's the Messiah. He's the Christ. He's told me everything that I've ever done. So they all come out of the town, and they are just enamored with Jesus and his teachings, and they beg him to stay. Will you please stay with us? And they end up staying a couple more days. Disciples were not happy, all this stuff. So the thing that I want to focus on is the reaction of the people. So those in that passage, those people come out, they are enamored by Jesus, they love what he's doing, they love his teaching, they ask him to stay. Will you abide with us? Will you dwell with us for at least a few more days? And the disciples were like, we got other stuff to do, we got to go. But Jesus says, no, that we're going to stay here. And they do. If you go to the other story that I was using, the demon-possessed man, they get on the boat, they go across the Sea of Galilee, they go to a place. They get off the boat, demon-possessed man runs down to Jesus, bows in front of him, and calls him Jesus, Son of the Most High God. So already in both stories, from my perspective, the disciples, if I was one of the disciples, I'd be like, holy shnikes, what is going on? We go to one place, he talks with a woman, now we got a demon-possessed guy coming, bowing at his feet, calling him, giving him the authority position, all this stuff. And then he heals the demon-possessed man. The pigs run into the lake. All this stuff. Then here comes the thing. The herders go back into town. They tell the people. The people come out to see Jesus. Very different reaction. Very different reaction from the people, the Samaritans, right? So the people come out. They see the demon-possessed man in his right mind, clothing on, not screaming, not yelling, not trying to hurt himself. And they go, Jesus, you have to leave this area. And so I boiled it down in front of my class. I think we're one of those two types of people. Either we go and we want Jesus to abide with us and dwell with us on a daily basis, or we see Jesus show up in the midst of our life and then we ask him, hey, you got to go away. Or maybe we don't ask him. Maybe we tell him, like, we don't want you here. And the reality is, both cases, he answered their request. For the Samaritans, he stayed an extra 2 days. For where he was in the Gerasenes, those folks, they came, saw what he did, healed the demon-possessed man, and they asked him to leave, and he left. So I just boiled it down for my students, and maybe this makes sense to you, and this is just, maybe it's just for me, but I want to share, because I think there might be some others of you out there. I think there's two types of people. We either ask Jesus to dwell and abide in what we do, and we want to be about his word, and we try to live that out on a daily basis, or we're like the other group of people that we see Jesus show up in the midst of something, heal somebody, do something incredible, and then we get a little timid about it, and we ask him to go away. So maybe today, instead of telling him to go away or asking him to go away, maybe we just ask him, Jesus, will you abide with us today? Will you walk with us? Will you lead us? Will you guide us? Will you direct us? I've been doing this Proverbs challenge, and what's interesting to me that throughout the Proverbs, it says when we ask, if we will seek, if we will ask for wisdom, if we will seek it like silver and gold, then it will be given to us. So maybe today, if you would just seek, if you would just ask him to dwell and abide with you today, then he will do so. So thank you so much for all the support. Hope this blesses you. Remember, keep worshiping and God bless.